How to turn your life around. Well, I'm not an expert in this, but I do have some experience. I was in Michigan. I graduated from college. I was unable to find and really keep a good job. And I had to make a change. I got tired of living in my mother's house. So I decided to go online, put up a post on Facebook. I had a YouTube channel, so I had plenty of followers. And I basically said that, hey, this is my degree and I want to go down south and find a job. And this guy who I never met, never knew of, said that, hey, I have a job for you. Gave me a link. I went to the link, I applied. The next day they called me for an interview, over the phone interview. And it went well. And a week later I packed up all my stuff into my Chevy Express full-size van. And I drove to Kentucky, from Michigan to Kentucky. Didn't have any family in Kentucky, didn't know anybody in Kentucky. When I got down here, it was definitely a culture shock, but I had to make some changes. I had to change my attitude. There were times where I quit jobs because I thought I was being treated unfairly, but I had to grow up and realize that life isn't fair. And I was in a certain situation where I needed to produce, I needed to provide for myself. So I was very fortunate to have that opportunity. I was able to work at a rehab later on. I was able to work at a shelter. I was able to work for an offender reentry program where we were actually helping. I was working as a counselor. I was actually able to help people make that transition from jail to on the streets and actually try to turn their lives around. I've seen people make a lot of mistakes. I've seen some people make it. You know, I'll be in the grocery store and somebody walk up to me and say, hey, thank you for helping me. You helped me when nobody else helped me. And that's a really good feeling. Then, of course, you hear about people ending up back in jail, worse. So, I want to talk about some of the, how to really turn your life around. The four big factors I've noticed with people in addiction, I'll say not just people in addiction, people in general. When they want to turn your lives around, if they can do well in these four categories, they usually have pretty good success. One, attitude. If your attitude is, the world owes me something, the world has victimized me, not gonna work. If your attitude is, I'm only gonna do this if this and this happen, or somebody else does something for me, it's not gonna work. You have to have a can-do attitude. You have to have an attitude where you're gonna make it happen. For example, if somebody comes out of jail and they're like, well, I only wanna work a construction job, I only wanna work a line job, I don't wanna work fast food, I don't wanna do this, not a good sign. Okay, your attitude should be, I don't have anything, so I'm gonna work whatever job I can get. I'm gonna save some money and get myself a place. That should be the attitude, okay? So the attitude, number one, you don't have the right attitude, it's not gonna work out for you. Two, productivity, very important. You gotta be doing something. Addicts cannot be stagnant and not having anything going on. They say idle hands is the devil's playground. Well, whether you're religious or not, if you don't have anything positive going on, it's gonna be really easy for you to slip into something negative. Okay, you get bored, you're on Facebook, and you come across that old friend, that old girlfriend, old buddy wanna hang out, and you know what that person's up to. Okay, you know what's going on. All right, third factor, support system. It's hard to do things on your own. You gotta have somebody usually there to help you out, somebody who, even if it's just emotional, just encouragement, you know, somebody to talk to. When you're feeling down, when you feel like you can't do it, somebody to talk to, some type of support system. And another thing that's tied into it, the fourth one, is who you surround yourself with. You could have the greatest attitude. You could be super productive, always working. You even have mom and dad or brothers and sisters who support you. But if you are surrounding yourself with some sketchy people, people who are gonna encourage you to make bad decisions, you're setting yourself up for failure. So that's just a reality. Those four factors are huge. Some things I noticed on a side note with females, whether it be addiction or whatever, recovery, the guys they hang out with. Whew, one of the biggest factors in a lot of women struggling. And they could be doing so well, but if they're hanging out with their boyfriend who's not trying to change his life, who's still messing around with drugs, who's currently in jail, not doing the right thing. Those guys pull those women into the abyss. One of the worst things for the women. One of the worst signs. For the man, you know, it's all, I don't want this type of job, I don't want that. You know, it's a lot of little things that sort of trip people up too, just decision making, you know. You know, people wasting all their money on energy drinks and cigarettes and vapes. Some people vape and they smoke and all this other stuff, and you don't really have the money for that. If you're coming out of jail, you're trying to turn your life around. So, these are just some things to keep in mind. So, hey dog. So, if you want to turn your life around, got to have the right attitude. Got to be productive. It means you got to get off your butt. Helps to have a good support system. And surround yourself with positive people. Positive people. If they're always putting you down, they're always putting other people down, they're always blaming other people for their mistakes, they're never taking a responsibility for what they're doing or their outcomes, it's gonna affect you. You know, the people you surround yourself with, they are a reflection of you, whether you like it or not. They're gonna start to influence you. Doesn't matter how positive your attitude is. And I notice that especially with women too, but men and women all the same. So those are my thoughts for today. How to turn your life around. Something to keep in mind. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.